إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is about to receive a new year, a new Hijri year. Today is the last day in the year 32 after 400,000. Tomorrow is the first of al-Muharram. 1433 years, brothers and sisters in Islam, from the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And I wanted to remind my beloved Ummah of their status. Look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about you. والحديث في سنن الترمذي ومسند أحمد، حديث بهز بن حكيم عن أبيه عن جده، وجده هو معاوية بن حيدة وله صحبة، قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: أنتم توفون 70 أمة، أنتم خيرها وأكرمها على الله أو عند الله. You are number 70, meaning there are 69 nations lived in earth before you, and you are number 70. You are the best ummah and the most noble ummah in the sight of Allah. And I wanted to remind my beloved ummah of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about you. قال تعالى: كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You are the best ummah ever raised up for mankind. But يقول عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه: من سره أن يكون من هذه الأمة فليؤدي شرط الله فيها.
If you really want to belong to that best ummah which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about in that verse, you must fulfill the condition. And the condition is mentioned in the same verse. كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس الشرط تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. Because you enjoy what is good and the best of goodness in the face of this earth is calling people to tawheed, and you forbid what is evil, and the worst of evil is shirk, and you shun shirk. Brothers and sisters in Islam, يقول أهل الأصول إذا علق الحكم بوصف فالحكم يثبت وينتفي بوجود أو انتفاء الوصف. Meaning, you are the best ummah provided that you enjoy what is good and you forbid what is evil and you believe in Allah. But if you do not enjoy what is good, if you do not forbid what is evil, if you do not believe in Allah, that means you are not the best ummah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر, enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil, is a mandatory task upon the members of this ummah. The adilla, the evidence, قال تعالى وَلْتَكُنْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةِ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. Let be a group amongst you, call people to what is good, enjoy what is good, forbid what is evil. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما أخرج مسلم في صحيحه من حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره. Whosoever amongst you sees evil, he must change it. بيده, his hand. فإن لم يستطع, if using the hand will bring about negative consequences or will bring about harm to you, then فبلسانه, use your tongue. And also, if the usage of the tongue will bring about a greater evil than the evil which you're trying to enjoin, or it will bring harm upon you, then فبقلبه, then use your heart. وذلك أضعف الإيمان. And this is the weakest. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is mandatory upon every single Muslim to enjoy good and forbid evil with the heart. لا ينفك عنك الإنكار بقلبك بأي حال من الأحوال. When you see evil, your heart must dislike it, must hate it, and you have to do it. And if you don't, then serious consequences will follow. But once it comes to the hand, once it comes to the tongue, balancing and assessing the consequences, benefits, negative consequences is a variable. حساب المصالح والمفاسد. Or if it will bring you harm, that's another variable. Probably the widespread of evil in our societies, in our homes, sometimes in our masajid, is a result of abandoning that duty, brothers and sisters in Islam. الإنسان الآن يسير في الشارع. Now you walk in the street. يعني You don't know. Evil here, evil here, evil there, evil here. Brothers and sisters in Islam, الأمة على صنفين إلا من رحم ربي. You will find the Muslims belonging to one of these two categories. Once it comes to enjoining good and forbidding evil, accept. There are people who do it, but very few. صنف, one kind that abandoned this task totally. ترى الرجل, you see a man walking next to his wife, متبرجة, not even dressed, and his own home لا يحرك ساكنة. And they do this because of misconceptions, شبهات. Top of the line, يقول لك حرية شخصية. دي حرية شخصية يا عم الحاج, أنا مالي ومال. It's a personal freedom. يا أخي من قال هذا؟ You wanna tell me that the prophets whom Allah sent to mankind throughout history are interfering with the personal freedom of the individuals? Shame. Shame if a Muslim says it. Say this. Shame. حرية شخصية. يقول لك لا إكراه في الدين. طب الكلام لا إكراه في الدين هذا لليهودي والنصراني. This is for the Jew and the Christian. You talk to them about Islam, but you cannot compel them to become Muslims. We're talking about Muslims here. لا يا إخوة. There are enough evidence in the Quran, in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which mandate upon you achieving this task. That you see evil, you change it. Another misconception, a verse actually, في سورة المائدة, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا عليكم أنفسكم لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم. O ye who believe, be responsible just for yourselves. No harm on you as long as you're guided. The obvious meaning of the verse, a license not to enjoin good not to forbid evil. ووعى لهذا الصديق رضوان الله عليه. الصديق paid attention to this verse. كما صح في سنن أبي داود قرأ الآية. He recited the verse. And he said, أيها الناس, O people, you recite this verse, but you apply it wrong. By Allah, I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, if you see somebody committing evil, and if you do not seize him or her, if you do not stop him or her, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inflict you with a collective punishment. وذكر الإمام ابن جرير الطبري رحمه الله قول ابن المسيب سعيد قال من تمام الهدى أن تأمر بمعروف وتنهى عن منكر. The ayah says, as long as you're guided. Now, in order for you to be guided, you must enjoin good and forbid evil. Another misconception. يقول لك الناس ما بتسمعش. ما انت عمال تغني في مالطا يقول لك ما انت you keep going, you keep saying, but nobody's listening. It's not your job. It is not your job that people respond to your enjoining of good, forbidding of evil. إن عليك إلا البلاغ. Your job is to deliver. Your job is to speak about it. Whether you follow it or not, that is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I share with those who have abandoned the enjoyment of good and forbidding of evil some of the serious consequences so that they may go back to their senses and they do something about it. You know the most dangerous consequence of not doing this task? Is the corruption of your heart. When I see evil and my heart does not react about it, that means you like it. That means you like it. وذلك روي عن سفيان الثوري أنه قال, if you see evil, and your heart likes it, as if you have done it. And if you hear about evil, maybe I switch it about around. If you hear about evil, and you like it, oh, somebody comes in. You know this guy, he was walking with those two nice, beautiful girls. And he went to the bar. You did not see it. But in your heart, curse. The heart is corrupt. But if you see it and you deny it with your heart as if you have not seen it. Ya ikhwa, as a matter of fact, the most difficult tool to enjoy in good and forbid evil is the heart. It's actually difficult if you pay attention to it. And listen to this hadith. Hadith ibn Mas'ud. وهو في السنن أيضا سنن أبي داود والنسائي. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن أول ما دخل من النقص على بني إسرائيل. I'll give you the meanings in English. The first sign of corruption that emerged into Bani Israel. That a person will meet another person who is committing evil. فيقول له يا فلان. He tells him, ya fulan, oh so and so, اتق الله. Fear Allah. Haram. And at night he goes and he eats and drinks with him. لا. If you use that heart, you have to separate. وقد نزل عليكم في الكتاب أن إذا سمعتم آيات الله يكفر بها ويستهزأ بها فلا تقعدوا معهم حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره إنكم إذا مثلهم إن الله جامع المنافقين والكافرين في جهنم جميعا. If you see somebody messing up with the deen, don't sit with that person. As long as you're not going to change, don't. Because if you sit, you'll like him. If you change that evil with your heart, that means you have to separate. You have to see off the person. You have to delete from your contact list. Another consequence, brothers and sisters in Islam, is الطرد من رحمة الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dismisses you from His mercy. Which means اللعن. قال تعالى لعن الذين كفروا من بني إسرائيل على لسان داود وعيسى بن مريم ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه. Cursed the children of Israel, the disbelievers of them, in the tongue of their messengers, عيسى عليه السلام and داود. Why? Because they used to see one another committing evil and they do not speak about it. They do not change it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, another consequence is if you do not change evil in your environment, just wait. The whole environment will be corrupt. The whole environment will drown in corruption. وهذا بين من حديث النعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنهما وهو مخرج في البخاري قال صلى الله عليه وسلم مثل القائم على حدود الله والمداهن فيها أو الواقع فيها كمثل قوم استهموا على سفينة. Hadith. The likeness of those disobedient and those who enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil is like a group of people who got on a ship. The ship has two levels, upper, lower. Some of them got into the lower deck of the ship and some are in the upper level. The people in the lower level, in order for them to get water, they have to go up. So they kept bothering the people upstairs. They, you know what? We have a good idea. We have a very good idea. We're not going to bother you anymore. We're going to dig a hole in the bottom of the ship and get our water. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if the people in the upper level do not hold their hands from doing this, the whole ship will drown. And this is what is happening in a lot of our communities, brothers and sisters in Islam. It's drowning. drowning in disobedience. Why? Because the people in the upper level are not doing their job. Brothers and sisters in Islam, another punishment, collective, another consequence, collective punishment. في صحيح البخاري أم المؤمنين زينب بنت جحش رضي الله عنها قالت, she says, دخل علي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم فزع فقال لا إله إلا الله ويل للعرب من شر قد اقترب فتح اليوم من ردم يأجوج ومأجوج فقالت يا رسول الله أنهلك وفينا الصالحون قال نعم إذا كثر الخبث. Woe to the Arabs, evil. Today the wall that Dhulqarnain built was dug that much and he made a circle with his fingers. Then his wife asked him, Ya Rasulullah, can be a collective punishment when there are some righteous people amongst us? He said, yes, if adultery spread, riba spread, why those righteous people are not speaking? Brothers and sisters in Islam, يقسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو الصادق. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم took an oath and he does not need to. والذي نفسي بيده, حديث حذيفة بن اليمان رضي الله عنهما, والحديث في الترمذي, والذي نفسي بيده, by the one in whose soul, in whose hand my soul is, لتأمرن بالمعروف أو ولتنهون عن المنكر أو ليوشكن الله أن يعمكم بعقاب ثم تدعونه فلا يستجاب لكم. By the one in whose hand my soul is, you better enjoin good, forbid evil. Otherwise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inflict you with a collective disaster. Then you call upon Allah, oh Allah, take it away, help us. And your dua will not be answered. That is category number one, brothers and sisters in Islam. There is another category of Muslims who do enjoy good, but without good. And they do forbid evil, but with evil. Because they don't have the knowledge. This task, brothers and sisters in Islam, it's complicated one. It requires the assessment of al-masalih wal-mafasid, the benefits and the negative consequences of you performing that act. Not every time that you speak, you're going to bring about good. Actually, you could replace that evil with a greater evil. Brothers and sisters in Islam, إذا أردت أن تأمر بمعروف, وهذا من نفيس كلام شيخ الإسلام طيب الله ثراه, إذا أردت أن تأمر بمعروف فلا بد وتنهى عن منكر فلا بد من علم يسبقه ومن رفق يصحبه ومن صبر يعقبه. If you want to do that task, you must acquire the knowledge of how to go about it. When can you do it? When cannot you do it? When you cannot do it? The condition of the person in front of you, can he afford you talking to him? حساب. وذكر ابن القيم رحمه الله أربع حالات, four cases. Case number one, that you change that evil and you replace it with good. Then you have to do it. يجب. Case number two, that you change that evil with a lesser evil. Then you have to do it. Case number three, the evils are equal. Then ask a person of knowledge. Case number three, case number four, that you replace that evil with a greater evil. Then it's haram to do it. ولنا شواهد كثيرة في السنة لولا حداثة قومك بالإسلام لنقضت البيت. حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها. Brothers and sisters in Islam, فقيه السنة الإمام البخاري بوب. He had a chapter in his book of knowledge, and listen to what he said. باب العلم قبل القول والعمل. Knowledge must precede you speaking or acting. العلم بالمسألة. Knowledge of the issue. Knowledge of the issue. في المسألة هذه فيها خلاف ولا ما فيهاش خلاف؟ خلاف سائغ ولا غير سائغ؟ يعني قرأت أن بعض الناس he could not afford somebody raising the index in the salah, he cut it next to him. يعني رآه منكرا, he saw it evil. طب ده كلام, طب هذا خلاف سائغ. فknowledge must come before doing the act. Number two, brothers and sisters in Islam, is الرفق. Forbearance. لما دخل يهود على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and they said to him, السام عليك يا محمد. السام means death. وهذا الحديث أصله في البخاري, but this is the wording of Muslim. حديث أنس. Group of Jews, they entered into the house of the Prophet ﷺ and they said, السام عليك يا محمد. السام is death. فقال لهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعليكم. هكذا ترد على غير المسلم. فخرجت عائشة غضبا. عائشة came out of the house angry and upset because she understood that they are calling Allah to make the Prophet die. Death be upon you, O Muhammad. That is what Aisha understood. She started yelling at them, وعليكم يا إخوان so and so. انظر ماذا قال لها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا عائشة, الرفق. الرفق, forbearance, kindness, tolerance. إن الرفق لا يكون في شيء إلا زانه ولا ينزع من شيء إلا شانه. وإن الله يعطي على الرفق ما لا يعطي على العنف. فإف you want to enjoy good and forbid evil, you must go about it with kindness. Don't be mean. Don't be rude. Don't be aggressive. Don't. People do not like to be told what to do. يا أخي, النفس لها سلطان. Inside each one of us there is a pharaoh. I don't like to tell me what to do because of my nafs. Now do it nicely. In private, remind the person of what is good and nicely. Al-rifq comes in a sabr, patience, Because this is the work of the messengers and the prophets. And if you are in the business of enjoining good and forbidding evil, rest assured that you will get it. يقول لقمان لابنه وهو يعظه يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف وانهى عن المنكر واصبر. If you do this, you must be patient. Because not everyone will like you. You will find a lot of people who will dislike you. Because you're telling them what to do. So be patient. Brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, because of the nature of the subject, I have decided بإذن الله تعالى and with his tawfiq to throw 4 lectures between Maghrib and Isha on Saturdays. فقه الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. Where we'll talk about the pillars, the condition, the etiquettes of the person who enjoins good and how he should go about it. How can you treat the person whom you're trying to help and how you go about it in details, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله قال تعالى واسألهم عن القرية التي كانت حاضرة البحر إذ يعدون في السبت إذ تأتيهم حيتانهم يوم سبتهم شرعا ويوم لا يسبتون لا تأتيهم كذلك نبلوهم بما كانوا يفسقون. A story of the stories from the stories of Bani Israel. وأمرنا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في حديث ابن عمر عمرو ابن العاص رضي الله عنهما أن نتحدث عن بني إسرائيل. حدثوا عن بني إسرائيل ولا حرج. وفي رواية فإن فيهم الأعاجب weird things. A town that overlooks the sea. And normally if you live by the sea, the first job you go for is fishing. They requested a day on which they do not do any worldly things at all. And they will devote this day solely just for the remembrance and the obedience and the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah told them Saturday. But look at the test. Throughout the week, they go fishing. Not even a small fish. On Saturday, they look at the sea. The fish is going around in the top of one another. You know that upper part of the fish is showing. And for a fisherman to see that upper part, if you are a fisherman, يجن جنونك. Saturday fish, throughout the week no fish. What are we going to do? Deception, trickery, deceiving Allah. They place their nets, their artificial streams so that these fishes or fish, I don't think there is a plural for fish, will go inside these nets. And on Sunday, they will pick it up. So this way they have not violated the Sabbath, in their opinion. Like a lot of Muslims now, they violated with a trickery. Let me deceive Allah. He knows هو حرام الموضوع. عارف. الإثم ما حاك في الصدر. وإن أفتوك. I always get, is riba, is margish haram ya sheikh? Margish haram ya sheikh? Ah haram ya khuy. طب الشيخ the other sheikh told me it's halal. Why are you asking me then? Because inside you're not comfy with the sheikhs. If they started fishing, eating the fish, the community divided into three groups. One group ate and filled their belly, committed the evil. And one group stood up, enjoying good and forbid evil. Haram! Riba haram! Selling alcohol for a Muslim is haram! 70% of the liquor stores in America is owned by Muslims! Haram! Mortgage haram! The third group said, why are you doing this? They are not listening to you. You keep saying haram and they still buy. معذرة إلى ربكم ولعلهم يتقون وإذ قالت أمة منهم لما تعظون قوما الله مهلكهم أو معذبهم عذابا شديدا قالوا معذرة إلى ربكم ولعلهم يتقون. Why are you speaking to them? You've been talking to them, but they are not responding. أخي, I'm gonna keep talking about it. My job is to speak, and I'm gonna speak. Whether they listen or not, that's their job. معذرة. So that Allah sees that I have fulfilled my task. They did not listen. So they said, you know what? Let's build a wall between us. They build a wall. So the people who are eating the fish in a separate part of the town, in one of the mornings they woke up and they noticed that they didn't come out of the gate. So they looked and they found monkeys. Monkeys. Allah changed them into monkeys. When they opened the gates, subhanallah, يقول ابن عباس that the monkey used to come to his relative from the people who used to enjoy in good and forbid evil and smells him. I remember you. I'm a monkey now. And then, haven't I told you? Amazing brothers and sisters in Islam. الطابور الخامس, this group, the third group which stood in the middle. They did not eat the fish. And at the same time, they are blaming for those who are enjoying good and forbidding evil. Allah did not mention anything about what happened to them. فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ. Those who used to enjoy good and forbid evil, we saved them. وَأَخَذْنَا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا بِعَذَابٍ بَئِيسٍ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. فَلَمَّا عَتُوا عَمَّا نُهُوا عَنْهُ قلنا لهم كونوا قردة خاسئين. Which of the groups you want to be? You want to be the group that enjoins good and forbid evil? I commend you. Or if you want to be from the other group, the group that violates the laws of Allah, or if you want to be with those who dance on the stairs, they just wait. If it works, I'm with you. If it doesn't work, I'm with you. مذبذبين بين ذلك لا إلى هؤلاء ولا إلى هؤلاء. وفي ناس كده في الجاليات في النص يشوف الغلبة فين هكذا. But brothers and sisters in Islam, if you want to be from the first group, remember, acquire the knowledge. Remember to do it with kindness. And remember to be patient. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. ثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه. وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم ربنا هيئ لأمة الإسلام أمر رشد يعز فيه أهل طاعتك ويذل فيه أهل النفاق والكفر ويهدى فيه أهل المعاصي. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.